today I'm back because I have a project to share. And this is a design team project that I have created for Trezors Deluxe. And I just wanted to share with you guys because I am really in love with this project. I think it turned out really pretty. And I know that we have a bit of an unusual camera angle here, but I just wanted to show you guys the whole of the project. So I'm probably just gonna turn this around. So as you can see, here is a dress form. And if I turn it around, I have created a beautiful umbrella for the dress form as well. And actually, when I had this idea, I was looking online to see if anybody had done anything similar because I was looking for a tutorial maybe or inspiration, but I haven't found anybody. So I just had to wing it and do it my own way. And I think it turned out really beautiful, so I really like it. And so this is what it looks like all the way around. And I actually have this balancing on a vase at the moment. So just turn this around here for you guys to see. And so I'm probably going to change the camera angle now so that you guys can have a better look of everything. Okay, so hopefully this is a better angle. And so I'm going to give you guys a run through what I did and how I did it. But I just wanted to let you guys know that every item that I have used from the Trezors Deluxe Etsy store will be in the description box so that you guys can head over to the website and check it out. I'll also have all of the links that you need to find the store and Facebook page, YouTube channel, and everything else you need. So the first thing was, of course, the dress form itself. This is a papier-mâché dress form. I painted it and then I covered it with lace. I hope you guys can see. So I covered it with lace and then Mod Podged over it just to give a little extra interest there. And so there's two things about this dress form. Of course, the umbrella, as you can see here, that does come off and I will show you guys in just a moment. And the second thing about this dress form is the stand. As you guys can see here, that's what it looks like and it's decorated and everything like that. But it actually comes off like that. So if I put my lady here on the side. And so the first thing I did was I was looking for something that I could use as a stand. And the only thing I had around was this bottle of soda. And I'll probably try and have it on the screen so you guys can see how it started. So it was this metal can, it was a limited edition. I basically had it hanging around. So I painted over it and then I Mod Podged to lock in that color. Then I created the base with a piece of chipboard. So I painted it the same color and Mod Podged it as well. I then adhered the bottle to the base. And I decorated with these beautiful flowers. And this was actually a headband. It has these beautiful foamy flowers. And I love the color of these. So I wanted to use it with this dress form. The flower you see here is one of my handmade flowers. And by the way, you guys, I have had a ton of requests to do a tutorial on how I made these flowers. So I will have something very soon. I've already filmed the tutorials, I just haven't had time to edit them. So if you want to see how I made these, please stay tuned on my channel and I'll have the videos up as soon as I can. But anyway, this is something I created a little while ago and I posted it on my Facebook page. So that's how many of you guys know about these flowers. So this one actually comes off. I have got a pin on the back. This dress form was a gift that I made for someone, so I wanted to give her the choice of taking this flower out and using it on something else if she really wants to. So I'm gonna have it on there like so. And I used this beautiful pearl and bling center as well. So that's the base, and the bottom is nothing special. I just put some felt because I wanted it to protect the surface where the dress form is gonna stay. And the reason I haven't attached this to the dress form itself is because, of course, I'm going to be sending this in the post. So I wanted to have the option of wrapping this separately so that it doesn't break or damage or anything. Here's the dress form, and you can see here there's the hole where the bottle fits into. And the person that receives this, she can then just add a little bit of glue and have this permanently adhere to the base if she wants to, or she can just keep it like that and she has the option of just having the dress on the side or whatever she wants really. Now to the umbrella. So as you guys can see here, this is part of the handle And the handle of the umbrella goes all the way through the dress form. As I mentioned before, I was looking for inspiration, but I haven't found anything like this online. So I had to sort of come up with my own idea. So basically, the umbrella comes off. Okay, so here is the umbrella. And the way I created this, just a quick run through. I used one of these cocktail parasols or cocktail umbrellas, and they look like this. And you just open this up, and it's made out of paper. So I peeled off this paper. I then used some stronger skewers on each of these little sections here. And then I adhered it together with some ribbon, so you can kind of see. I wrapped it around just to hold that skewer in place, and you can kind of see the skewer here on the end. And then for the handle, I did the same thing, but I added, I think it was 2 or 3 of those longer skewers. And then I cut out pieces of lace to cover each of those sections. And I've added this beautiful crocheted doily on a top, and then I decorated with some beautiful Trezors Deluxe laces. And this lace that I used here is actually this one here, and I don't have a lot of it left, so I cut out these little scalloped edges here and just attached it onto the umbrella. And then I also cut out the little flowers on the end and adhered 4 of those. On the top here, I have a different lace from Trezors Deluxe, and it looks like this. So it's these beautiful flowers with the pearl in the center. So I cut one of those out and just adhered that on top here. And that is the umbrella. So I really like how that turned out. I wish I had an umbrella like that myself. So anyway, now to the dress form. So as you can see, the hole goes all the way from the back to the front for the umbrella to go through. And here is the dress form. This is the color that I used. So it's just this sort of like ivory color. And so I created this skirt with some satin fabric. And this is just this very vintage kind of a creamy beige color. And I really love this color. So it worked really well with this project. And I then created the skirt overlay with this beautiful lace from Trezors Deluxe. I am absolutely in love with this lace, and let me show you what it looks like here. So this is what the lace looks like, and you can see they're attached here on the end. And all I did was I just snipped that apart because I wanted it to go around the skirt, and if I left it like this, it was gonna make the skirt kind of like pull together like that. So I just snipped the ends of the lace just so that it hangs like this, and I think that looks beautiful. And on top here, as you can see from the lace itself, it has like this little scallop edge, so I just threaded some ribbon around so that I could gather the lace all the way around. So then I adhered that to the top of the skirt. On top here, I wanted to create the bust area. And so I've used this beautiful lace from Trezors Deluxe, and that's all I have left of that one actually. So this is what it looks like, and you can of course use that this way or that way, and that's what I did. So I used this 2 sections as the bust area, so that's pretty much what you see here on the dress form. And I adhered that to cover the, you know, the breast area. And then I tied this all the way around, so you can kind of see it comes down here. Then I just embellished this section right here, and I've used another product from Trezors Deluxe, and it's this beautiful velvet flower. And this is the pink one. And I absolutely adore these flowers. They're so vintage looking. And so it just added that extra something that I wanted here on this corner. I also used some white feathers and another one of my handmade flowers here. And here on the top, I have used a piece of jewelry that I had from my stash to create this sort of like a, it's like a choker. I think that's what it's called. I'm not sure. And I've also created this beautiful little cameo necklace. Also, I created the pearl necklace, and it kind of dangles here. I thought that that would add an extra nice touch. And as you can see, the bust area, like the lace comes down here, so it's kind of open in the center. I really like that as well. On the top here, I've added some pearls on the shoulder. And then on the back, the lace that I used to cover the dress form, it kind of joins on the back, so I wanted to embellish the back to cover that up, and it also gives a more professional look. And so that is the dress form, and that's what it looks like. So I really hope you guys like this project. I am absolutely in love with this. I made this with someone in mind, as I mentioned, so I really hope that she's gonna like this, because I know she loves dress forms and I know she collects it. So I just wanted to create something for her for a long time, and I thought that this would be perfect. So thank you guys so much for watching. As I mentioned, I will have all of the product codes down below in the description box so that you guys can check it out from the Trousers Deluxe website. And just one more thing before I forget. I don't know if you guys know, but Lucy, who is the owner of the store, has a promotion going. So when you head over and place your order, mention that Becca sent you and you will receive a free gift with your order. So yeah, just head over to the store and check out the products. They have beautiful laces and many, many other products as well. So thank you all so much for watching. I will catch you guys next time. Bye.